if we Brexit,
yes,
and we go into recession, would you have political courage and dignity go on TV and in Japanese style politicians say,
commit harakiri?
Sorry, no harakiri. Sorry, I made it wrong. And I apologize to
Bow and apologize.
Before.
Yeah, well, of course, Zelko, of course.
Seems that Boris Johnson needs to prepare his tentacles soon. And just a reminder, last time a person committed harakiri, he took 10 hours to die. As he's painfully waiting for his blood dripping slowly from his cross-like cut on his belly. For harakiri is a more ancient way of seppuku. No one is cutting your heads off in the height of suffering. I guess this would be enough to scare Boris Johnson off from keeping his promise. Both him and Nigel Farage, the party leader of UKIP, are both announced as the Brexit passed the referendum.
And if we vote leave and take back control, I believe that this Thursday can be our country's Independence Day.
The sun has risen on an independent United Kingdom. And just look at it, even the weather's improved.
And thinking this would make Britain great again. However, as Cantonese idiom said, making promises like eating lettuce, British people may have realised they are being duped already.
The £350 million a week we send to the EU, which we will no longer send to the EU, can you guarantee that's going to go to the NHS?
No, I can't, and I have a nice feather bed.
After 17 million people have voted for leave.
Yep.
And as a friend of mine wrote, the Brexit camp may not have enough officials and politicians to execute triggering Article 50 of Lisbon Treaty. Anyway, British people have spoken. Great Britain is going to leave the European Union. This may be something, as David Cameron said before the vote.
Our economic security is paramount. It is stronger if we stay. If we leave, we put it at risk.
There are lots of articles talk about different aspects of Brexit. However, I would love to address something I observed on this referendum with great concern. Xenophobia. Some narrow-minded crabs like white supremacists or so-called Hong Kong localists, especially living in overseas like Canada, really love to celebrate that anti-immigrant sentiment is the reason Brexit won this referendum. They believe immigrants escalate the conflict within British society, drain British social resources like free health care.
Your new National Health Service provide you with all medical, dental and nursing care. Everyone, rich or poor, man, woman or child, can use it or any part of it. There are no charges.
Old age security, etc. For the Hong Kong localists, they even think of Britain as Hong Kong and the European Union as evil mainland China.
想問問老師咧點睇咧？英國脱歐對香港嗰個啟示係咪其實都係香港都會有一個咁嘅可能嘅，即係脱離咗中國嗰啲樣嘢。
英國脱歐同香港嘅情況唔可以比擬嘅，因為英國係一個獨立主權國家啦，佢加入歐盟係一個貿易聯盟啦，最先最後邁向類似一個聯邦政府，但係仲未係嘅聯邦政府啦。
I'm especially upset some who come from the same city of mine and living in Toronto have a similar point of view. This is in fact dangerous. In Canada, we are all immigrants and we pay the same effort to improve the same society, our new home in Canada. However, some of them still dare to believe immigrants are the parasites. Some of them do have established career. Some, however, whom I don't want to be specifics, is in fact benefit from this very society of EI because of his mental illness. I just wonder, what if they are being viewed as the garbage of Canadian society? This is not something we've not seen before. When the Nazi Germany siege power in 1933, they slowly exclude the so-called alien members of the society. Jews, mental illness, Jehovah's Witness followers, roamers, then finally kill them in doves. Xenophobia doesn't only stop people from moving into the society, they will also destroy those already moved in. In the era, Canada feared of Chinese and Japanese immigrants robbing local jobs. They riot to crush Chinese and Japanese businesses.
The famous Vancouver riots were in 1907, I think.
And what can you tell us about these riots?
They were not directed solely against the Japanese, of course. They were both against the Japanese and the Chinese. And there had been a certain increase in immigration just in those few years. But they did lead to a number of Occidental mobs storming Chinatown and Japantown.
What was happening to them can happen to us too. Meanwhile, immigrants has become an essential element in Canadian society. In a newest Statistics Canada report, local-born Canadians cannot keep up with the job demand, and most of them is now taken over by the immigrants. Immigrants, in fact, has become the backbone of Canadian economy. Without them, our welfare system would simply collapse. So to speak, xenophobic rhetoric would threaten, even destroy our society, not making it better. And those white supremacists or so-called Hong Kong localists living in Canada are in fact the traitor of us Canadian values and should be put to jail. This will be what the Great Britain is facing after the referendum. According to latest poll, 75% of British youth is supporting staying in Europe compared to most older people supporting Brexit. Simply put, the youth would have to live the longest under the consequences after Brexit.
I think it's pretty terrible because it's our future. We're the ones who are going to have to live with the decision.
I feel like it's an outrage that we have left the EU. I think it's a totally wrong decision, and we're not pushing humanity forward by walking away from things.
They've come out and they've done this. It's just a last up yours from the baby boomers. Bought up all the houses, crashed the economy, and now they've dragged us out of the EU against our will. So we're just going to have to find a way to get around it.
And to avoid the grim job market as well as the hopeless economic future, they will probably move out of Britain.
It just feels like things are beginning to break up. So for us, potentially for our children, if and when we were to ever go back or they were to go back, they're going to have to jump through a load of hoops that they would not have had to have done yesterday.
News has it that lots of them are searching for ways to come to Canada. More probably, they would use the 2 years Britain staying in European Union to go to Europe for a better future. The British government would lose a big chunk of people they can tax on to keep the welfare and feed those who can only stay in the Isles and dream of the revival of British Empire. The once mighty empire which colonized half of the world and resulted partly today's refugee crisis would now become the source of refugee. History, in fact, is full of irony.